إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أصول السنة للإمام أحمد بن حنبل وعند the topic of the Salah. On that topic we divide in two parts, importance of the Salah and abandoning the Salah. So importance of the Salah, we are in the third lesson of that topic. We read it, the topic of Imam who have right to lead the Salah. And we said, if the masjid has regular Imam, he's the one who is leading the Salah. Whether you are elder than him, whether you are more knowledgeable than him, whether you know Quran more than him, he has been appointed. So the chapter is closed. But when there is no appointed Imam, and for some you want to appoint an Imam, or you are together as a group outside the masjid, you want to pray. So what's the category? In Sahih Muslim, عن أبي مسعود الأنصاري قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أم القوم the people should be led as an imam by who أقرأهم لكتاب الله the one who will know well the recitation of the Quran. That's number one. But the people, they all learn the Quran. So sometimes, فإن كانوا في القراءة سواء. If they are nearly equal on the recitation, we can differentiate between them, which is better. You look to فأعلمهم بالسنة. The one who knows the sunnah more. How you know he knows the sunnah? You want to ask him if he can read Bukhari by heart? How you can know? Look his appearance. Shaved his beard, wearing trousers, dragging his garment. That's not following the sunnah. And the worst is if he's smoking. So you look to the sunnah from the person. فإن كانوا في السنة سواء. If they are all equal or nearly equal in the issue of the sunnah, which is the third category. فأخدمهم هجرة. There's no hijra. We are in a place where we're born. Yeah. So this title is not on us strongly. فأخدمهم سلمًا. Who accepted Islam first? And then when we visit someone, or someone visits you at home. وَلَا يَؤْمَنَ الرَّجُلُ رَجُلًا فِي سُلْطَانِ in your authority, your small kingdom. Yeah? No one should come from outside to lead you in the Salah. Accept your permission. If the Sheikh comes to your house, you invite him, he ate, have not had to lead the Salah. Unless you give him permission to lead Salah. So in your house, you are the one who is leading Salah. And it's a disaster if you don't know how to lead Salah. It will be a disaster. Number two, the guests who are coming, they will sit where you are appointed for them. Sit in there and don't sit in there. It doesn't mean they will enter and they sit where they like. When they enter, they should wait for you. And then you let them to sit where you want. And then when you bring the food, you should not start eating food unless you give them permission. This is your kingdom. Yeah? You are the king in there. And everyone should respect you. So, وَلَا يَأُمَّنَ الرَّجُلُ رَجُلًا فِي سُلْطَانِهِ وَلَا يَقْعُدُ فِي بَيْتِهِ إِلَّا تَكْرِمَتِهِ عَلَى تَكْرِمَتِهِ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Someone can't come to a house and sit except your permission. Except you give permission to come in and sit. Otherwise, not allowed. So this is the stage you look for the Imam. Sayyid al-Tirmidhi an Anas bin Malik qal, qal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. من صلى لله 40 يوما في جماعة وأفعل برايز إن الجماعة 40 days إن الجماعة 40 days look at condition يترك التكبيرة الأولى attentis the first takbira it's very difficult 40 days and you attend the first takbira the imam kutiba lahu bara'atani yeah 2 points you'll be free from them it will never happen to you bara'atu min an-nari you are free from hellfire with the strength of the imam. 40 days, 5 salats. Yeah. In the first takbira, you are in the masjid with the imam. وَبَرَاءَةٌ مِنَ النِّفَاقِ And you will never be munafiq. You are not munafiq. You are not munafiq at all. Safe from the nifaq and safe from the hellfire. And the condition is to pray in the jama'ah with the imam the first takbir in 40 days. Who can do that? 40 days roughly 200 salats, isn't it? That is where yeah, you prove yourself. Yeah. You are on the right path when you do it. Sahih al-Nasa'i an Abi Darda qal قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم important of the jama'ah here even at home try to call people to pray together قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من ثلاث there's no 3 men but jama'ah is obligatory on men not the women so 3 men في قرية in a village ولا بدوين or in the rural camp in the rural area 3 men and what they do لا تقام في الصلاة they don't establish the salah as a جماعة they don't pray in جماعة إلا قد استحوذ عليهم الشيطان شيطان yeah, is coming yeah, to control them شيطان is a boss now you didn't follow commands of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم So you are following commands of the shaitan. And you see after a while, that 3 are fighting each other. But shaitan is doing his job. So means you have to be careful about the jama'ah. فَعَلَيْكَ بِالْجَمَاعَةِ Stick on the congregation. And Prophet ﷺ is giving example of the rural life. Maybe all of you or most of you that you don't know. Yeah. When you have a flock of sheep and the wolf comes, wolf doesn't jump in mid of the flock to take one, no. Yeah. He looks only one goes on sight. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the wolf eats, which sheep eats? Al-Qasiyata. Yeah. The one who is straight from the group. So if you don't pray with the group jama'ah and you are sight, you own, shaitan will take you. It's a meal for the shaitan. In the Sahiha al-Albani, عن أبي درداء رضي الله عنه. أبي درداء رضي الله عنه. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المسجد بيت which is a house you should look after the masjid as you look after your house you should be in the masjid more time as you be more time in your house المسجد بيت كل تقي every pious person Don't see you a lot in the masjid, that means there's no biases. We can't rule on you, you're not biased unless we see why. why? Yeah. Are you far away from the boundary of the masjid? Are you busy working and unable to leave? You see why? But masjid should be as your home. More time you should spend in the masjid. But every time you are running back to the masjid, you go to work, you are tired, you are hungry, you run back to your home, you see. Yeah. As that way, you should run back to your masjid every time. Sayyid Abu Dawood, عن البراء بن عازم قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله ملائكته الله عن لوس أنجلس يصلون بليس أمكتع for them who على الصفوف الأولين in the first rows when you come you pray on the first row. But this condition is to pray on the first row. The first condition is, you come earlier, and there's space in the first row. But when you come late, and there's 5, 6, 10 rows in there, and you jump off of them to reach first row, you are not right. You are not getting the blessing of Allah and His angels. So if you need first row, come earlier. Where there's space in the first room. Especially Friday, be aware of to come in and try to pass a row or two to reach somewhere empty. Avoid that. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, whoever comes and squeeze row after row, jumping over the shoulders, Allah will make him breach on Judgment Day. And they walk on him. So when we come back, when we come to Jum'ah, until where rows ends, sit in there. Turn, squeeze, and come forward. You see someone, even they don't know any space, but just they are pushing and pushing and pushing until they try to come as much as possible. And then they are squeezing between two people. That's not right. So, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى الصُّفُوفِ الْأَوَّلِينَ. صحيح مسلم عن عثمان قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى العشاء في جماعة وإف بريس صلاة العشاء in congregation فكأنما قام نصف الليل as he stood up for the tahajjud half of the night. Big rewards. And then ومن صلى الصبح في جماعة if you pray Fajr in congregation كان ما صلى الليل كله as you prayed all the night half of the night from Isha half of the night from Fajr. البخاري narrated عن أبي هريرة قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس صلاة أثقل على المنافقين the most pardon salah, the most difficult salah for the munafiqs to come in the Fajr or Isha. It's the Fajr and Isha. But if there is some livelihood reason, they will come to Fajr and Isha. But not for the sake of Allah. وَلَوْ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا فِيهِمَا if they know the rewards which you will get when you come Fajr and Isha, لَأَدَوْهُمَا they will come to attend. وَلَوْ حَبُونَ even if they are crawling, that's where we miss, even if they are crawling. Yeah. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لَغَدْ حَمَمْتُ certainly I want to do. What do you do? An أمر المؤذن. I command the مؤذن to announce Iqamah. So when Iqam starts means the people are praying. Who are not in the masjid at that time, they are not praying with the jama'ah. You can't rule against someone just because of the adhan. Adhan started, you are not in the masjid. You can't say that. But Iqamah started, you can say you are not in the masjid on the Iqamah. So Prophet ﷺ had half right to lead the salah. What's he doing? ثم أمر رجلا يأم الناس. And then I will get someone to lead the salah. So Prophet ﷺ started praying in that case. What job he's doing? ثم أخذ شعلان شعلان من النار and take flame of fire, sticks of fire. فأحرق على من لا يخرج للصلاة بعد. And I burn the house of those who don't come to the salah. The punishment. Burn them alive in the houses because they don't come to the salah. The Prophet didn't do it for the reason why. There's children at home with jama'ah not wajib upon them. There's wives at home with jama'ah not wajib upon them. So why you are burying them? So Prophet Hassan didn't do it. But it shows how severe is the person who don't come to the salah to be punished. Sahih Muslim. قال ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه maybe please you see that this morning رضي الله عنه قال ولقد رأيتنا if he was going to see us a companion وما يتخلف وما يتخلف عنها and no one will stay behind the jama'ah. You all come to the jama'ah. Illa accept munafiqun ma'lum al-nifaq. Accept the hypocrite person. We know he's hypocrisy. We know he's hypocrisy. We know he's munafiq. That's only one stays behind. All others, you come to the jama'ah. In this topic, the salah brings sustenance, a rizq. Normally, we kill ourselves to get wealth, to get money. You work and work and work. On top of that, you work overtime and overtime and overtime. Why? You're looking for money. And that can lead us to miss the salah. Or to pray salah cook, to pray salah in wrong places. Because we can't look for sustain. As the way we are now, and pray salah as well as required. So which one we should drop? Drop the salah. Drop the salah. Some people, they open haram business. When we talk to them, why you are doing that? They have answered, prepare it. You have family, and we don't have any other income. You can't get a job. You have to look after family. Look after family, 10 years, 20 years, 40 years, and then you will die, and you will be punished in your grave millions of years. So what do you earn? What do you benefit? That's a problem. So when you focus on your salah, and look after your salah, the sustain will come to you. The rizq will come to you. I'll make it easy way for you to earn. But if you don't know what you need, money, 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 that means there's no barakah on the money you are earning. You don't see that. Regardless of the amount of the money you earn or you have it, there's no barakah, you don't see it as enough. And that's because you are far from salah. We stop here, inshallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وعلى اله وصحبه ومن تبعهم باحسان الى يوم الدين.